you might call it the daddy or the father of English clockmaking. I feel like taking a bow to that great man, Thomas Tompion. Born 1639, he died in 1713. This is one of his most magnificent, most technically advanced bracket clocks of around 1700. Thomas Tompion was first referenced as being a clockmaker in London in 1670 off Fleet Street. His association with the Nib family of clockmakers, together with the skills of the French and Dutch Huguenots coming over in the 17th century, refined his clockmaking to a quality which then was unrivaled. This clock is remarkable. It's an ebonized bracket clock on these bracket feet with lovely gilt ormolu detail, but importantly, it's a quarter repeating bracket clock. Very advanced with subsidiary seconds dial here, the silver dial with the Roman numerals and the beautiful Baroque spandrels in the bottom left and right corner. And he built over 5,500 watches and 650 bracket clocks, of which this is one. Such a masterpiece because of its ingenuity, together with its robust construction, attractive technical movement and mechanism, makes the complexity of a Tompion clock like no other, but gives efficiency in operation. This clock survives because of a sound construction, and concealed within this glazed side panel is the quality of the movement, which is so advanced for what this clock presents over 300 years later on, since the time of Charles II. This clock today represents a legacy of a man who really was the father of time. We expect this clock in our fine art sale to tick away. It might keep ticking, as it will hopefully realise between £120,000 and £150,000. A frightening clock, but for its position in that league of clockmakers, it's at the very top.